Do you think you can convince me, this old school dude, who's never used this? What do you think?
I would definitely say so.
Those were the famous last words of Alexander Lichter, who told me, Tim, dude, Tailwind CSS is the shit. You should try it. So I told him, but okay, why don't we do a Tim Tries video? And instead of me just trying it blindly because I haven't used it before, why don't you explain its context to me? And then once I know how it kind of works or what it's used for, I'll just try it and see if it's actually something I like. So, let's go. Hello, Alexander. How are you? Welcome to this latest fancy version of Tim Tries.
Hey, Tim. I'm fine. How about you? Happy to be here.
All good. Hey, man. So, I know your name is German. At least I'm expecting it's German. Could be Austrian. So, you know, I'm Dutch, right? So I have the ability to have some sort of sound of German, but I'm sure I didn't say it right in the intro. So would you mind pronouncing your name the right way for people?
No problem at all, but I think you did pretty well. So it's Alexander Lichter, and it's German indeed.
It is German. So your Lichter is lighter than mine because I'm from Amsterdam and we sound a bit rough, I think.
Ah, okay. Yeah, but still very good. Very good.
So you'll see in the final video if I did it right. Anyways, so as I said just now, this is a Tim Tries video and not really an interview because we're trying this new thing and you're now the first guinea pig to help me out on this. And I'm sure it's going to be fine. But so in this video series, I tend to try new things that I've never tried before. And then I give my opinion based on what I see. And hopefully I have enough experience with stuff generally in my career to be able to give an opinion that makes some sense. However, isn't it more fun to look at something with an expert or even the person who made that product so they can give a bit of context so I don't always sound as stupid, maybe? I don't know. So in this video, we'll talk about Tailwind. And can you maybe tell a little bit of the story why you are an expert or like how did you get involved with all this stuff?
Yeah, so of course, I haven't made Tailwind at all. Tailwind is made by so many amazing people and contributors, but I'm using it for, I would say, almost all my projects. Tailwind CSS itself, it's a utility-based framework. And I think, so I was following Adam Weathen, one of the creator of Tailwind CSS, along with some other nice folks. Every now and then, he showed some live streaming and he used some of his own custom CSS framework in there. And people always were like, oh yeah, that's so cool. Could you open source that? And some point back then was written with less. So, and then it was like, yeah, maybe he should do that. And from that idea, eventually Tailwind CSS has been created. And I like the idea because it's not like Bootstrap or Bulma or whatever. So you don't have components that are built in already. You have all utility classes. So for various CSS properties, and then you can compose components out of these utility classes. And it's so nice because Bootstrap is cool if you have some like rapid prototyping. But if you build like your site and you say, okay, that navbar, I maybe want to customize it a bit, then it gets annoying pretty quickly because you always work against the framework and you never have that feeling with Tailwind because you own the whole part that's only a bunch of HTML classes and divs. And if you want to change something, it's so easy.
Okay, this is starting to sound better than I thought because I'm old school, right? I never use frameworks. I was wondering if you could convince me to use this and you're starting off really well. Because
nice.
When I started to use Bootstrap, because at work we did that, I looked at it and I'm like, okay, no, I'm sorry, but this is not going to work. We need certain quality, certain whatever, it just wasn't working. So since then, I've not really gone into all of this. But the fact that it's utilitarian, that's pretty cool. So I went to the Tailwind CSS website and I decided to go for the cart example. I took the HTML and put it in my empty Nuxt project because I am Nuxt, so why not use Nuxt? You know, Nuxt has this great implementation with Tailwind. They have all these configuration options. So I thought, let's put it in. So on the right side, you see the Tailwind HTML. And then on the left side, you see my own old school CSS and HTML. So I decided I'm just going to rebuild this thing without sus, without less, nothing special, just old school CSS to just see the difference in effort it takes to get this and to see what the output of the quality is also. So when you scale this, you see there's a bit of a media query going on. And in what I've learned, and that Alexander also explained, in Tailwind, I only had to actually add CSS clauses to get this result. So let's look at that code. You can see I have two sides, right? So in the code, in side one, I kind of didn't use any of those inline clauses that Tailwind uses. I just called it cart and cart header and cart body because, you know, I'm a dinosaur. We used to name things semantically in HTML, so you know always what this thing is. Anyways, this is the CSS. You can see lang post CSS because that is actually, you have to use that for Tailwind, even though I don't use that here, but whatever. So you can see cart, cart header, cart body, and you know what? I can keep scrolling. It's kind of a lot of code. And then there's even the media queries. And I realized, looking at this, to get this same result, especially with the media query and the typography and whatever, it kind of was tedious to build. This is like a good 100 lines of CSS for something relatively simple. And of course, I didn't use variables and whatever because old school CSS. So I had to, you know, repeat myself for colors and border radiuses and whatever. And then I looked at the Tailwind thing. And so let's just open it in the code here. And you know what? My old school heart starts to cry and bleed when I see these kind of classes like rounded T or background cover or, you know, large flex. And this is just because what I'm used to is having this semantic naming, right? So I would say in the context of this screen size, my cart header does this in CSS, separation of concerns completely. Because what happens if the cart header changed something over time and somebody just adds some, whacks some CSS in it and then listens to one of the classes that was added there? If that class says it's pink and you add purple, what you see and what you get as a result is no longer the truth. And of course, back in the day when we didn't have like fancy post CSS and automation and linting rules, you know, these kind of things always went wrong. But nowadays we got really far, and I'm starting to see there's actually a benefit to this, because if you only use Tailwind, why would you ever write extra CSS unless it's like super special? You just look at the class because you know this is now our new alphabet and you just change it. And the other day, I have to be honest, I was working on something and Alexander's voice was in my mind. And so I was working and I thought, what if I could just make this flexbox by just typing something in the HTML and just, or make a grid layout or something. And actually I was like almost feeling like, oh, maybe this Tailwind approach is kind of cool. And so, well, Alexander, you pitched it well, let's be honest. And maybe I just have to stop complaining and just stick to the rules. If these are the CSS clauses we use to make this work, and then we use post CSS to purge stuff and to really make the rules and make it super optimized, why not just go with it? Question, who is this not for?
So I would say people could have a hard time when you have lots of dynamic content and maybe what you see is what you get, editor. But even there, I think with the right integration, that would work nice. And one thing, so I have a couple of projects where I didn't reach to Tailwind CSS, mostly because it's a bit of work to customize all the things. And sometimes just to wrap up a quick MVP, it's nice to have all the components built in so you have less work.
So what is Tailwind based on? Because you said it was based on less before, but I'm going to assume that's not the case anymore because of performance and scalability and stuff.
Yes, correctly. So you don't need a preprocessor anymore, and it's based on post CSS, on that cool post processor. So that gives lots of flexibility. And also, for example, if you run Nuxt.js, then, or mostly any modern web project, then you use auto prefixer, or it's at least included by default. Sure. And that means it is using post CSS already, and you don't have a bunch of time to process, for example, SAS files if you use SAS again. So it's even quicker during your HMR or during your build time.
Yeah. Which basically means you can also do all the optimizations post CSS comes with, including like stuff like Purge CSS, right?
Yeah, exactly. So Purge CSS, this is also a nice topic. For a long time, Purge CSS was recommended along with Tailwind CSS to reduce the CSS coming from Tailwind. So all the classes that you don't use, they will be simply stripped out of your CSS. And now even Tailwind made a step further and integrated Purge CSS into Tailwind itself. So you don't have to mess around with like whitelisting some classes of your custom CSS or of your animations. What happens is now that Tailwind's classes will be purged only. And if you add some custom CSS or some transition classes, they will be kept.
Oh, that's cool. Because knowing me, I will probably do some custom CSS because I'm just not fluent enough with Tailwind. So do you ever do custom CSS in these cases, or you don't even need anymore?
To be fair, very rarely. So there are scenarios why, but usually I add another utility class, to be honest. Mm-hmm. So back then, when Tailwind wasn't adding rotate classes, and I have some rotating squares on my portfolio, I just added a rotate 45 class, so it will rotate by 45 degrees, and that's it. But of course, if you have some very complex scenarios, it makes sense to add custom CSS there, but I usually keep it to a minimum.
I can imagine, based on what I've seen, why would you have more complex stuff than this? Probably not true. I might have to just get off my high horse and try this stuff. And just
do that,
thing is, I probably just have to dive in a bit and actually look at it. Listen, man, this was great. I think this is a really nice form of Tim Tries. I haven't been as salty as I normally am. But that's very also because you explained it well and the Tailwind thing actually will work. So I want to thank you so much for joining me today. And hopefully see you soon. Cheers.
Yeah, thanks a lot for having me. And see you around.
All right. Cheers, man.